Welcome back! Ginanap ka makailan sa Cagayan de Oro ang two-day event na Football for a Better Life na parte ng isang grassroots football program na pinangunahan ng ilang current and former members ng Philippine Asgals. To tell us more about this, kasama natin sina Misag Badonan, Graham Cagill, at Albert Almendrelejo. Welcome back to The Score, guys. Thanks for joining us. Albert, welcome back. First of all, year two
ng
Football for Better Life. Grab a mic, please. Tell us more about it.
It's year two, Teach, and we're doing another 10-city tour for this year. And we started that in Hingoog. And around 10 other provinces nearby participated. So it's the Regional Football Association of Cagayan de Oro, Agusan, Butuan, and all that. So for the first time, Hingoog, which is a city in between Cagayan de Oro and Butuan, hosted such a football tournament.
Okay. And so they never had a football event this big?
Never in its history. So the people there were very happy.
Okay.
Especially we brought the two billboard stars. One is the star of C5.
And they play some football, by the way.
No. They didn't display their abs for a change. No? And the other one is the billboard star of Guadalupe. Okay. So, but they went there for football and the kids were very happy.
Okay, tell us about your experience, Graham. What was it like down there with the kids?
Yeah, it was an amazing experience because my mum is actually from Mindanao. She's from Nasipit, which is very, very close to Butuan City, where we flew to.
Cool.
So it was an amazing experience for me to go back there and inspire kids from my mother's province.
Mm-hmm. For you, Misag, you've done some camps in the past before, but what was it like being in a province like this? And as Albert said, it's the first time they had something like that for them.
I really enjoyed watching the kids trying to play football instead of playing different sport. Mm-hmm. It was something new for these kids. And then we saw so many kids, they wanted to do football and they now had chance because of Pro Life to have this kind of opportunity to show their skills, to show how they are, how they can run, how they have skills of playing the ball with the feet. But they really enjoyed, and so many participants was there, and then we really enjoyed. So I was kind of surprised that the city that they don't really have, the province that they don't have that much football, but when they found that there will be something like this, there's so many kids they show up, and really enjoyed.
And Albert, what was it like? So what did you prepare for them? Aside from, I know there was mini tournaments, but there was a camp as well. Tell us about the coaching part of it and how it was, you know, teaching the kids as well.
Okay, there was a clinic for Balay Pangarap. It's a street children project of the mayor. And Chiefy was there to conduct the first day clinic, Misag and Graham. No? Okay. So we followed the FIFA standard of teaching football 101 for kids 6 to 12 years of age.
Okay.
Right after the clinic, there was a tournament, age group tournaments, starting at 8 years of age until the open for men and women.
Wow.
Okay. And
so
well,
all these age groups
were there.
Yeah,
nice, and great, James Young husband was the one that did the awarding, so you just could imagine the joy that the kids had for this kind of event.
Graham, what was it like? What did you see in the kids' eyes when, you know, it's one thing for them to play and to learn, but to be so close to actual football stars and football professional players?
Yeah, it's so good to see them being inspired by people like Misag and Chiefy and James, who play for the national team. What a great aspiration for them to aim for.
Can you put yourself in their shoes? Like, if you were that young and you actually got up close and personal to a football star, and you live in the province, the likelihood of you, you know, getting in, you know, in close contact with them and for a sport you love.
Well, it is similar for that for me, because when I was playing in England, I looked up to these guys like Misag and Chiefy and Phil Younghusband, James Younghusband, and now I've played alongside them, I've played with them, so it really is like a dream come true for them.
Misag, for you, what do you think it's like for these kids? You know, they see you guys up close. They get a good camp, they get a good training and a good competition. How long can this experience go for them, and how will it help them?
Because as everybody mentioned here, that this was like kind of inspiring kids to do. And it's the most important for me was the kids have a new path to change their life. That's why this football can change these kids' life, especially this comes, if they work hard, they can go to free education, a scholarship, and joining national team and get some money or something out of this and change their life, just hard work. And that's what makes me happy, that Pro Life and this grassroots will teach these kids and give them new way of life to change their life, instead of going doing like things that is necessary, like drugs or this. They they join these football things. And
for Albert, man, Albert, you know, through the years, this has been more like an advocacy for you. It is work, but it's an advocacy as well, to bring football players, football coaches to the provinces. How fulfilling has it been? I mean, this is year two. Obviously, you don't want to stop. You want to keep doing this. So, kamusta yung pakiramdam para sa'yo?
Well, as you know, well, soccer economics, it's a book. No? And yeah. They said that for any country to succeed in football, you need three things. Number one, basically support of the government, which we don't have. A big population, which we have.
Yeah.
And number three is basically exposure of the kids in playing football.
Right.
So the more time you play football, the better for us.
Mm-hmm.
This program serves as a feeder program before they go to the national team,
which
starts at U14. You know? That's why Chiefy was there trying to look for kids that had the standing
for his team. That's right.
And from there, maybe take care of them, give them scholarship, try to recruit them in schools in Manila. So it's really something that we can offer for a better life for all these kids.
How big is that? Let's say on that note about Chiefy. I mean, this is something he started after he, you know, retired from the Ascos.
Yes.
He's been going around.
That's right.
How was the experience of Chiefy and, you know, helping the kids in the provinces as well?
Actually, last year we had almost 10,000 kids that participated in Football for a Better Life. A number of them landed in scholarships in La Salle, in Alabang, then La Salle in Green Hills, even in San Beda, now even in Letran. No? So this is the trend that's keep on cropping up. Yep. There's so many talents in the provinces.
Back in the day, wala tayong ganyan.
Wala, puro NCR. When you do a national team, it's all basically
that's
NCR.
Yeah, correct.
Now, in the national team, 80% are from the provinces.
Right.
So, and Mindanao is really represented. There's a very strong football movement in Mindanao.
I mean, these guys in the UFL, you now play against some of the kids who's come from the provinces. Graham, for you, interesting perspective, what would it be like for these kids to now get exposed to Manila football, you know, much earlier in their lives, rather than some of them end up playing Manila football in college only? They play their high school, grade school back in the provinces, but as early as they can get better competition, how big of a boost is that for them?
It's a massive boost. If you play football abroad, like in England where I was brought up, people start playing at 4 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old. It's so early and it just gets ingrained in your blood to play football.
Right.
So as the earlier, the better for anyone to play football.
Absolutely. Misag, for you, the more, you know, the better competition, you know, not to put down the football in the provinces. It's great starting there. That's a grassroots. But of course, when you converge here, when you're a varsity player for your grade school or high school, how big is that for them? For the future of football to develop as well for the Philippines?
This has really helped the national team and the club and the level of Philippine football leagues and Philippine national teams, because if the kids started playing in age of 5, that means they've been passing the ball more than us when we started in age of 16, 17. Or in
That's
college.
How late you started?
Yeah, I started 24.
Seriously?
Like a professional player.
Wow.
But if you started playing I'm kind of jealous of these kids that Chief is going to teach these
They're starting
kids
at five,
5 years.
Yeah, exactly.
And then when they get age of 17, for them, that means they touch the ball more than I did. So they get in better professional football playing. Sometimes I teach some kids, now they are in UFL and play against them.
Yeah.
I feel like, why these guys are faster than me? Why I didn't have the chance when I came to Philippines to play football as early as possible. Yep. But now with Pro Life and this grassroots thing, really this helped them, not only kids, the football and the country develop faster.
And remember, TJ, we brought 11-year-old kids in the UK to train 3 years ago.
That's right, yeah.
And these kids
are now 3 years ago.
Gano na kabilis, so
the little Ascals.
Now they're 14 years old and they're part of the national team, no?
Fantastic.
So they went to the UK.
So a lot of them are with Chiefy's team.
That's right.
Great.
That is the trend, no? Expose them, bring them abroad, train them. Then from there, hopefully, we can have a stronger team.
For groups like you and the private sponsors you have, how important is it that this is not a one-shot deal, that this is a long-term commitment?
It should be a long-term commitment because you cannot do this on a part-time basis.
Yeah.
It has to be continuing. You keep on increasing people to play football at the same time, support, no? A wider support from private sector.
Yep.
Hopefully, the government can come in eventually. And this one is being done with the Ascals Foundation.
Right.
That's why we have all this Ascals with us whenever we travel.
Great.
Because that's the one way we can inspire them. So they know the Ascals. Wherever we go, everybody knows about the Ascals.
Of course.
And that's the way how we can hopefully give hope to these kids and keep on playing football.
And now football fever is heating up, of course, because we're going to host.
That's right.
The Suzuki Cup, you know, just around the corner. So tell us the dates, the next cities and provinces you're going to visit.
Well, the next date would be in the Magueta City. You know, we'll be there August 20 and 21. Then from there, we go to Dipolog, Tarlac. We even go to the Davao del Norte, then all over. So Barotac Nuevo also in Iloilo.
For sure.
And all the others.
So for more information, there is their website, Facebook page.
Yes, okay. Just Pro Life UK, Football for a Better Life.
There you go. Look for that and you'll find all the information there. Yes. Guys, thank you. This is a great thing that you're doing for the kids out there, and all the best. Maraming salamat.
Thank you, TJ. Thank you.
Susunod na, isa na namang football superstar lumipat sa Manchester United. Stay with us, please.